हेलो,
गुड आफ्टरनून लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन। आई फर्स्ट मस्ट थैंक द टेलीमेडिक्स ऑर्गेनाइजर्स टू गिविंग मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू प्रेजेंट द यूजर्स पर्सपेक्टिव टू द टेक्नोक्रेट्स एंड द एक्सपर्ट्स इन दिस फील्ड। आई एम अ लेमैन कंपेयर टू द टेक्निकल एक्सपर्ट्स हु आर देयर इन दिस field like a square peg in a round hole, but the square peg matters because this is the pivot, because we are the users, we are the ones who would then take up your services or your gadgets for the best utilization in the industry. The second day of the seminar post lunch is a very positive sign. I take it very positively because nobody has an excuse to take a break. It also leads me to another thought, that while we heard all the aspects in fleet management, drivers' behaviors, this post lunch syndrome gave me a thought. I didn't hear, maybe I missed out. If somebody has got a gadget which prevents a driver who's driving on the best of roads, highways, freeways, and dozes off because the speed's good, the wind's beautiful. I don't know. But yes, as a keen driver myself who loves to take long drives, and also suffer from sleep apnea, my friend gifted me a small gadget which I could put on my ear, and even if I nodded my head to look at the brake pedals, it started bleeping. Just a food for thought. Breath analyzers, of course, are there. What about the company that I come from? Checkmate Group of Companies, one of the leading companies in the security industry, a 500 crores plus group, earning its credibility since 1986, have got five different verticals. Electronics is also one of them, facility management, one of the global type of fire institute and disaster management institute in Baroda. And the banking vertical, of which I am the CEO. It's a user session for the users to give their wish list. So that is why I have not given it any agenda or any presentation. I just want to explain what we do, for the experts to pick up as to how best they can put the technologies, softwares, and gadgets to our benefit. The industry that I come from, if I can give a data from the FICCI data report, the private players providing banking services to banks, like ATM replenishments, cash in transit, movement and storage of gold and bullion, cash processing, doorstep banking, there are about 5,000 vehicles on the road every day, moving about 25,000 crores, which is exposed, with a number of 40,000 people who are in this industry. Now, what do we do? We move, we don't move newspapers to be there at your breakfast table. We don't move milk to be there for the child before he goes to school. We don't move perishables. But what we move, if we lose, the companies perish. At any given time, the average amount carried in a van is about 5 crores, 10 crores. And when it comes to bullion, it could be 50 kgs, 100 kgs, maybe 200 kgs. With this scenario, all this long about 32 years, 25 years in banking, we came in with this technology to safeguard the interest of our own organization as well as a service provider, because I've been on both sides of the fence. We got into technology for our cash in transit somewhere in the early 2000s. Had a lot of teething problems, had to go in for a lot of research, one-sided, and went into a lot of issues. It was the GPRS, it was not the satellite-related coordinates that were taken, and one of the coordinates that the tower it connected, it showed that location. Now, you generally knew, but you could never be sure. And as a security professional, where the worry is security, you need to be know exactly where you are. Then we came to know that we didn't have maps. So how do we relate the coordinates? How do we track? So we had a company come up with a laptop in the car, and wherever the car moved, the map was drawn. So we made it for the major cities, metros, or certain risk-prone areas. The next step, we started moving, but then there was no report coming from the van. We called the vendor. What happened? It found out that the vehicle was parked in a garage, or it was under a covered area, and the antenna had to directly be open to sky. All right, second time, what happened now? He says somebody's fiddled with the antenna. Going over all these issues for the GPS, then we said, okay, we are not worried or bothered about point to point. It left, it reached. How do I know that it reached the right place, and if I want to divert it, or if it has to send a signal back to me? All these sensors for isolation, door closed, door open, have little meaning when we come on to major macro level worries that we have. Was the radio communication. It could sound an alarm whenever it found that it is in a difficult situation, but how does it transmit back what sort of a situation it is? We got colored buttons designed with a radio that if this is the message, then he means this. If this is the message, then he means this. Now, we went over these years with the development taking place in the technology advancement, and then we realized that there's another factor which has come in. You buy the hardware. Now, if you found that this is an outdated hardware and you wanted to come on advancement of technology, replace the system, it had no interface, or the company didn't want to give an interface. Now, while we don't want to put all the eggs in one basket, but then we cannot also have too many players to monitor, too many colors on the screen to watch. So selection of the one that met our requirements in toto was also a difficult scenario. I know in 2014 we are much, much better off than what we were in 2002, and over a period we have developed, we have gone ahead, but our worry still remains. I'll quote some live incidents that happened in my direct purview to explain what pain points we have. Fuel, repair, maintenance, servicing schedules, all that, yes, it's good. But what about losing 10 crores? We had a case between ahead of Ranchi, at an isolated spot, the crew decided to stop. A short break. Later on, we came to know there was a small tea chap sitting there. And that's the time that these people came from all around and took the van away. Now, the van that time, because for risk management we had kept it low, it was 5 crores. We lost the van. We lost the money. And we could not trace it because the SIM card did not work in that area. Now, there was, all we knew that up to this point, this van was there, and after that, there is no communication. The van was detected about a week later in a burnt state, with the cash boxes broken. One person died, one of the crew members was murdered. The money is yet to be traced. We lost 5 crores, the technology couldn't help. Another case, we had a van traveling with 10 crores from Lucknow to Delhi. We did long movements. And there was a storm which had put the road jam. We had the GPS, we had the tracking, and we had a very good process to say that the crew traveling on a particular route will have the list of all the police stations, police posts throughout the route. And of course, they were on mobile. I was in Bombay that time when this van got stuck somewhere at Shahjahanpur. I got the number of the nearest police post of Shahjahanpur, about 20 kilometers ahead. Called up the SHO on his mobile, said, "I am such and such from Bombay. I have a cash van moving with valuables, and it is at such and such location." He said, "You said you are calling from Bombay. How do you know where it is?" I said, "We'll explain that later. But if you could go there, our boys would get some sort of a respite that the police is aware of it." I directed him with the color of the van and the location, exact location, and in 15 minutes, the police could trace where our van was, and they assured us that we've got the van pulled into the middle, and we'll keep a watch. We had a third incident. The vehicle was coming from Raipur to Nagpur. En route, the vehicle got shot. There were about 3 fires, and since these vans we were operating were bulletproof, we had those small cracks on the windscreen, front screen, and the vehicle managed to escape. It just rushed past. Thankfully, they didn't shoot the tires or put in those tortoise clamps. Now, I got a call, "Sir, this incident had happened, and this was 2 moves of 7.5 crores each. One had van had crossed the southern, this next one was to leave." It means that we have been detected, we would be moving out. Then the money was withdrawn and we had to move. I couldn't say that we don't. So I said, "Fine, in a time like this, all I can advise you, buy 2 meters of cloth. Go to the painter and write St. John's School Picnic. Put it on your van and move." They did just that. And the van came with 7.5 crores following the other one after 12 hours. Why I've related 3 different aspects to how far can technology save this money, which is our main concern, and not this fuel and driver's behavior and braking and accelerating and others. If the van reaches a certain spot and it comes into a dark spot, we need to have, the GPS will give me a reporting later of where all it went after that. But I'm worried about that time as to where was it immediately after that. Geofencing doesn't work. All it tells you, it sets off an alarm. The van has been left there, I know, okay, till here. My cash boxes have been taken away. That's value. And if my boxes have been taken away, how do I get to those boxes? In some of the Western countries, there is something to protect your cash in transit by spraying ink or incinerating the boxes when they are forcibly opened. The Reserve Bank of India does not permit us that. So how do I track that box? I should have an RFID to that box, but how long will that battery last? To get the police to come up to site, it may take me a day. How will I track that box as to where it has gone after the van was lost at a certain place? You have to have some sort of system to keep the RFID transmissions on for a reader to go and detect it. And then I must produce that reader there, because the police won't have it, to search for my own box or van. By the time I reach the van, quite possible, I get the box, it has been pilfered. Not an issue. Because I've reached to a certain place from where tracking becomes a little easier, unless it goes into the red corridor with one of those people who are yet to or within the police reach. My worry is not tracking a van. My van can stop at a particular place, but my box has to get escorted to the destination or to the door that it's supposed to deliver in. I need to have what we are now building at, the coordinates to match of the location of the van and the coordinates of the branch or the ATM. Unless these two match, my cash compartment should not open. Now, how far can that vicinity be? Where the coordinates which are there with the branch or the ATM and the van which is parked, the coordinates to match and say, okay, this is within the premises, within the reach, and this is the right place to offload the box and you can open the... Or I go in for a technology which I'm already using for my ATMs, is a remote controlled password released when the person who's filling that ATM asks for a password and I match it to the password of the ATM. But I can't have three different players, three different technologies interfaced, three different people monitoring and control rooms. It should be in sync, it should have an interface, and it should be workable. There would be many solutions. I've heard of solutions. Yes, it can be provided you pay for it. Yes, we are willing to pay for it. But gentlemen, in all practical purposes, these solutions cannot be bigger than the problem. So it has to be within the practical aspects, the business economics, the working and functions. Why do we use technology? We're using technology to reduce manual errors. In any one of the three incidents, it was either one of them. It was either the technology or it was the man behind the technology. Both of them combined together did not. So when we come on for offering a solution, or having an equipment, a software and a gadget to address a particular issue, it should also correlate to the business activity that it does. At the time that we were doing Cashvan GPS systems, we also are into guarding. We are also into escorting. We are also into monitoring. And we also do doorstep banking, that is cash pickup and delivery through two-wheelers. And we had the two-wheelers installed with the GPS many years back. And we had issues. The person complained that his motorcycle battery is getting drained. It does not start. Light does not come up because of the damn thing that you have fitted. And we said, okay. We went to the dealers and they said, the alternator of a motorcycle only has the capacity to charge the battery to a certain capacity. If the load is more, the lights will not come up, or the battery gets drained fast, or overnight it keeps blinking. We had those issues. We tried to do whatever, but were not very successful. It also gave out a practical issue that when the motorcycle got started, the battery didn't get charged. So he went a few kilometers before the battery had enough power to start power supply to the GPS. So said, we questioned him, you bloody left home at 8:30. He said, no, I was out at 8. It didn't match. Because that GPS only came alive at 8:30. Now, we were users. We are still users. I've still not become a wise consumer. Maybe more telematics would make me that. But why I'm only trying to remain as a user is I want to explain my pain points. I want to explain what matters to me. First is this: is the tracking of the cash box. That's the ultimate valuable that I have to deliver in time. To track that and not the van. If I cannot track the box, then my cash box should get secure inside a van so that even if the van needs, it needs some time for breaking of that box, of the cash compartment. I must have the SIM cards which are operative in areas where they would obviously take my van to break open. The service providers do not put in their towers where there are no customers or no requirements. So how do we address that? How do we address? We have cut off the crew. I know my crew has got nothing to do with where the antenna is. Now it's concealed. There are no wires. It is concealed. They don't know where it is. I'm tracking them for fuel through the GPS kilometers and petrol cards by filling up, topping up of tanks to the cutoff point every time. So even that I can manage. I'm managing and I'm monitoring by the petrol cards filling up of petrol tanks and the GPS tracking for kilometers. What the issue remains is tracking of that box, not getting it lost after a certain point, ki this is technology ends here. The technology should start from there. We were talking to a company yesterday on the two-wheelers as well as the RIFD tracking of boxes. Let's see if we can take that further, because these two aspects need to get answered. And major issue is, in case there is some advanced technology available, which is, and I'm using something which is obsolete, what do I do with that hardware? Is it a loss to me, or it can still be used as an interface? May not be for the total switchover, but at least in part, because I don't have that money wasted. These were a little journey that I could briefly spell out of what we started with, what we are today, about a little less than 1,000 vehicles is what I look after for my services rendered as of now. About 75% already have the systems. Rest are in the process. The softwares available, a combination of vehicle management system to fleet management system to GPS tracking to RFID is yet to be, you could say a combined synchronized solution. So we are open, and as far as I am open, the other players also in the industry are open and looking for solutions. That's all that I have to share as a user. If there is something more that you would like to know, which probably helps you take technology more closer, addressing my needs and my pain points, you're most welcome. If not, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for providing me this opportunity to at least give out our issues for you to ponder over and design something good for us, will benefit and save the valuables that we transport. Thank you very much.